हेलो सर, तुम तो आप
यस हेलो, मैं ऑडिबल। हेलो,
यस सर,
यस सर,
ओके ओके, राइट राइट राइट
सर,
राइट राइट। हाँ, देन लेट अस स्टार्ट। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट, कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन? यस, बड़ा बड़ा
यस
साहिब। ओके, हाँ ओके, थैंक यू। सो हियर we are discussing about the chemistry of alkane, and in that one we have seen the different point, and we are discussing about the preparation of this alkane. In this one, first, that is the industrial source of alkane. We have to see in the industrial source, you see that this petroleum is a major source of this alkane. Petroleum is a major source of alkane. From petroleum we can prepare the alkane. The word petra means rock, and oleum means oil. So means this oil obtained from the rock, petroleum. So this petroleum consists of mixture of gaseous liquids and solid hydrocarbon. So this hydrocarbon, that is alkane, is a major source of this petroleum, right? So from this petroleum can prepare this alkane. So petroleum is a major source of this alkane. Then next is the natural gas. So natural gas, generally it contains volatile alkanes, and this natural gas is also one of the chief constituents of this alkane. Generally methane or ethane, propane, butane, they are prepared from this natural gas. So here they are the volatile component, which on liquefaction we get liquids, and these are the major source of this alkane. If you see this petroleum contains a number of hydrocarbon, and this hydrocarbon or this petroleum, when undergo fractional distillation, when you heat at a different temperature, they undergo separated, and you can get the number of the fraction. So here you can get the different type of the fraction. For example, when this petroleum undergo fractional distillation, you are getting natural gas. So generally the alkanes having the boiling point below 20 degree, that is the hydrocarbon having the carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, like this one, means generally methane, ethane, propane, butane, they are obtained in the natural gas when this petroleum undergo fractional distillation. Other example, petroleum ether having the that is the boiling point 20 to 60 degree centigrade. So generally the alkane having the carbon C5, C6, means pentane or hexane, mixture of pentane and hexane. So they are useful as one of the important solvent in the industry or even in the laboratory. So petroleum ether. Other light naphtha having the boiling point 60 to 100 degree centigrade, and generally this orange compound having the carbon maybe C6 to C7, right? These are the orange compound, means hexane, heptane, having the low polarity. Similarly, natural gasoline, kerosene, gas oil or lubricating oil, petroleum coke, these are the some fractions of this petroleum. So here, when this petroleum undergo fractional distillation, you are getting the number of the fractions. And when undergo fractional distillation, and we collect this a different component, and you are getting a such type of hydrocarbon. And so these are the major source of this hydrocarbon. Here this is the industrial source, means on the large scale we can prepare this hydrocarbon. Let us see the laboratory method. In the laboratory, how we can prepare this alkane? So laboratory method, laboratory method of preparation of alkene. Laboratory method preparation of alkene. Preparation of alkene. Prepare any two preparation from each topic. They ask in general, write down the preparation of alkene, write down the preparation of so and so compound. So you can write in general, even in the in particular also they may ask. Number one. So starting from hydrocarbon. So for example, if you take alkene, RCH double bond CS2, this is your alkene. When alkene when treated with hydrogen S2, in the presence of catalyst like a platinum or palladium or nickel, so they undergo hydrogenation. Hydrogenation means there is an addition of HH on the multiple bond. So this alkene undergo hydrogenation and there is an attack of hydrogen on the multiple bond and you are getting corresponding alkene. Here is a H and also here is a H, means you get corresponding alkene, right? So as the hydrogenation takes place in the presence of catalyst, so we can say catalytic hydrogenation, or simply can say also hydrogenation, right? Catalytic hydrogenation, or simply say hydrogenation, right? Sir, lecture suru aahe majha, nantar karto call. Lecture suru aahe majha, theek aahe? Okay. So here, this alkene, when treated with hydrogen, you are getting corresponding alkene, right? So this undergo hydrogenation. So it is also called as a catalytic hydrogenation. Catalytic hydrogenation. Catalytic hydrogenation means the hydrogenation, addition of hydrogen in the presence of catalyst. Alkene react with hydrogen in the presence of catalyst like a platinum, palladium or nickel. It use corresponding alkene, so it is called as a catalytic hydrogenation, right? It is called as a catalytic hydrogenation, right? Now here we have seen this hydrogenation, right? Example, how to make example? I can replace this R by H, for example, right? Then it will convert into H, remaining part as it is. Here is a CH double bond CH2, so it is your ethene. It is your ethene. Ethene react with hydrogen H2 in the presence of catalyst like a platinum, right? Then here there is a addition of hydrogen on this multiple bond and you are getting corresponding alkene is a ethane, right? Corresponding alkene is ethane, so it is called as a catalytic hydrogenation. So ethene undergo hydrogenation in the presence of catalyst like a platinum, palladium or nickel, you get corresponding that is alkene, ethene, right? Another example, suppose this R is a methyl, right? R is methyl. Then next example, number one example, number two example, suppose just R I have replaced by the methyl group, so you are getting R double bond CS2. It undergo hydrogenation in the presence of catalyst like a palladium, so there is an addition of hydrogen on the multiple bond, carbon carbon double bond, so you add hydrogen on this H and on this H. Remember here, look here, I write the bond between the carbon and H, right? It is the correct. But if you write a bond between the H and H, wrong, right? So this bond should be in between only carbon H, carbon H, like this one, right? So starting compound is a propene. Propene react with hydrogen in the presence of catalyst, you are getting a propane. In this way you can write the number of example, right? So just you go on changing the substrate, you get the number of example. We have learned already near about 9R 10 R, right? So just you replace the R, you get the number of example, right? So first preparation, catalytic hydrogenation. Now next preparation, number two. So in this one, number two, reduction of alkyl halide, starting from alkyl halide, right? Starting from alkyl halide. So reduction of alkyl halide. Alkyl halide. You know what is meant by alkyl halide? Rx is alkyl halide, right? Rx is alkyl halide. So reduction means addition of hydrogen is called as a reduction. When alkyl halide, in general, Rx is your alkyl, R alkyl, X halogen, alkyl halide, when treated with hydrogen, two nascent hydrogen, how can get this nascent hydrogen? It can get by the reaction of C2H5OH methyl alcohol in the presence of zinc copper coupled metal. So this will react and it provides nascent hydrogen to hydrogen, and this hydrogen will add on this Rx. So there is addition of H on this Rx. So this H will add here, this H will add here, means there is addition of hydrogen on this Rx and there is a formation of corresponding, that is the compound. So RH alkane and HX, right? So you can get corresponding alkane, right? You can get corresponding alkane. So alkyl halide, when treated with that is the ethanol in the presence of zinc copper coupled metal, alkyl halide undergo reduction and it gives corresponding alkane. So it is a reduction of alkyl halide. Example, just you change the R and X by the halogen. So as the reaction takes place in the presence of, right, C2H5OH, and so here what happened, this C2H5OH methyl alcohol react with zinc copper coupled metal. So there is a formation of zinc, here is a copper, and O C2H5 taken twice, right? And there is a generation of hydrogen. You write in the bracket. So it is called as a nascent hydrogen. It is called as a nascent hydrogen. So as we require, we have to prepare and we have to use in the reaction. So it is your nascent hydrogen. You write in the bracket like this one. And this hydrogen will add on the Rx, right? So suppose if I take Rx like this one, suppose the starting compound is a methyl bromide. Methyl bromide react with nascent hydrogen, so the two hydrogen, right, reaction takes place in the presence of C2H5OH in the presence of zinc copper coupled metal. So this methyl bromide react with hydrogen and there is a formation of addition of H and addition of HBr. So this hydrogen will add on this CBr bond, addition of H, right? And there is a formation of corresponding alkane, means there is a formation of methane, right? In this way, we can write also a next example, right? Let us see another example, right? Suppose this R is ethyl, right? So CH3, then CH2, here is suppose Cl, it react with nascent hydrogen. How you can get this nascent hydrogen? By the reaction with C2H5OH in the presence of zinc copper coupled metal. So here there is addition of hydrogen on this CX bond and you are getting corresponding ethane, right? You are getting corresponding ethane plus HCl. So you get corresponding ethane, right? So in this way, we can prepare this alkane, means alkyl halide when undergo reduction in the presence of ethanol zinc copper coupled metal, there is a formation of alkane. So it is called as a reduction of that is the alkyl halide, reduction of alkyl halide. Next reaction, right, number 3. So here it is a name reaction. Also they may also ask separately, write down short notes on the Wood's reaction. It is one of the reaction, important reaction in which we prepare the, that is the alkene, starting from again alkyl halide, right? So let us see how we write the generalization. Wood's reaction, here the starting compound is your Rx, right? Rx, alkyl halide. It react with 2 molecules of sodium and again the 2 molecules of Rx. Reaction takes place in the presence of ether, right? The reaction takes place in the presence of ether as a solvent. So what happened in this case? Sodium from this, X from this, there is a removal of NaX, right? There is a removal of NaX, right? So here is your alkyl halide. Alkyl halide react with sodium and you are getting corresponding R and R, means alkene. You get a alkene, right? And plus 2NaX. So alkyl halide react with sodium metal in the presence of ether. There is a formation of alkane. RR means alkane, right? So it is called as a Wood's reaction. So starting compound is Rx, alkyl halide. This R and R dash may be same, may be different, and depending upon that one, we can get the number of example. Let us see the example of this one, right? So here, suppose if both R, they are same. For example, methyl, here is a bromide, right? It react with 2 molecules of sodium. At 2 molecules of methyl bromide react in the presence of ether, right? So Br from this and Br from this and sodium from here. So there is a removal of NaBr and there is a formation of CH3, means you get the ethane, you get the ethane, right? So you are getting the ethane and 2 molecules of NaBr, right? 2 molecules of NaBr, right? So this is your methyl bromide. Methyl bromide, right? This is your methyl bromide. Right, methyl bromide. So in this way, there's a formation of corresponding compound. Now here, suppose if R, they are different. For example, if I take R methyl, here is a Cl, right? Here is a 2 sodium and here is a Cl, and you take the C2H5, right? So R, they are different, then it undergo reaction in the presence of ether, right? So in this case, here there are the different possibility. Here what happen, the 2 molecules of methyl it react and you may get here CH3 one compound. Sometimes the 2 molecules of ethyl chloride may also react. You can get here there is CH3 CH2 CH2 and CH3, right? Similarly, one methyl and one ethyl it react and you can get here CH3, right? CH2 and CH3. So here there is a formation of a 3 compound, right? There is a formation of a 3 compound, and it is observed that when there is a more number of R carbon, that is a major, it undergo condensation. So here the N-butane is a major, right? The formation of N-butane is a major, right? And the remaining are the minor. So this is a major and remaining 2 are the minor compound, right? So in this way, there is a preparation of alkane, that is a Wood synthesis, right? So this is a one more preparation, and last preparation starting from Right. So last preparation starting from Grignard reagent. Starting from Grignard reagent. Right. Starting from Grignard reagent. So in the Grignard reagent, what is the Grignard reagent? It is RMGX. RMGX is a Grignard reagent. Alkyl magnesium halide is the Grignard reagent. Right? How we can prepare this RMGX? Right? So here, if you see preparation of RMGX, alkyl halide, it react with magnesium metal in the presence of a dry ether, then this Mg will go inside and there is a formation of RMGX. It is called as alkyl magnesium halide or Grignard reagent. So for this reagent, he got a Nobel Prize, right? So what? Why it is so important? Because this reagent is useful for the preparation of most of the organic compound. And now look here, this Rx is easily soluble. What is charge on this Rx? Here X is partial negative, right? And R is partial positive. So in case of alkyl halide, so if you see the charge on this Rx, R is positive and X is negative, right? So generally R is positive, right? But if you react with the magnesium, then you will see that there is a formation of RMGX, and you know magnesium is a metal. So here there is a partial positive, it is a dipositive, so it is a negative and also negative. Means here there is a preparation of R negative. So previously it was a positive, the R group, the carbon group was a positive, but you make it as a negative, right? Means there is a change in the charge. So here it was a positive, but you make it as a negative. So there is a change in the charge. That's why it is important, right? And so here, if it undergo hydrolysis of this RMGX, right? So this RMGX, if it undergo hydrolysis, addition of water, right? In the presence of a dry ether, right? So here what happened? Magnesium is positive, right? And R is negative, right? So here there is a addition of R negative, H positive, Mg positive, OH negative, and you are getting corresponding alkane RH plus Mg. Here is a X and here is a OH. So you are getting corresponding alkane. Right, you are getting corresponding alkane. So it is your Grignard reagent. So Grignard reagent, when undergo hydrolysis, there is addition of water and there is a formation of alkane. So it is called as a hydrolysis of a Grignard reagent. So you can say here the hydrolysis of Grignard reagent. Example, you can take R methyl, right? You can take R methyl, ethyl, or you can take any R that you know. You have learned near about the 9R. R, suppose if I take methyl group, methyl, here is a magnesium, here is a Cl, methyl magnesium chloride, it reacts with water in the presence of a dry ether, right? So there is addition of water takes place. So addition of H, addition of OH, right? And there is a formation of a corresponding alkane, right? There's a formation of corresponding alkane, that is a methane, right? So you are getting corresponding methane, right? Plus the byproducts are the Mg, right? Here is a Cl and here is a OH, right? In this way you are getting corresponding alkane. So in this way we can write the number of examples. So here I have written one example. Just you write R, maybe methyl, ethyl, or maybe any group, you will get the number of example, right? One more example I will take, right? So here, if you take, right, if you take such type of compound like this one, R is methyl, right? R is methyl, we will take in particular, right? R is, here is a CH3, CH2, CH, MgBr. So it is your secondary butyl magnesium bromide, right? It undergo hydrolysis, addition of water. It undergo hydrolysis, addition of water. So this bond will break, right? OH and H, and you are getting corresponding N alkene, that is the N butane. So in this way, you have to write the any example. And addition of H means you get the N butane, N butane. So again, there are the two preparation, right? One is the decarboxylation of fatty acid, decarboxylation of fatty acid, right? So next preparation, right? Starting from, that is fifth one, decarboxylation of fatty acid. Decarboxylation of fatty acid. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid is called as a fatty acid, right? R C double bond O, O minus and Na plus. So sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So sodium carboxylate is called as a fatty acid. So it is your fatty acid, right? Fatty acids. This, when you treated with alkali, NaOH. So reaction takes place in the presence of calcium carbonate. So there is a decarboxylation takes place. How? Here the sigma bond open on the R, R negative, C positive. So this negative will open on this sigma bond, formation of a double bond. There is a removal of CO2, and in the presence of here sodium, so there is a formation of sodium carbonate, right? So here you get R, addition of H, this H will attack here, and there's a formation of Na2CO3, right? Na2CO3. So in this way you get corresponding alkane, right? Example, if R is methyl, CH3, C double bond O, O negative and Na positive, it reacts with alkali NaOH, then you get CH3 addition of H plus Na2CO3, sodium acetate. Sodium acetate, when treated with alkali NaOH, so it undergo decarboxylation. There is a removal of CO2. So it is called as a decarboxylation. How? This sigma bond open on the carbon. There is a C negative, C positive. So this O negative will shift here. There's a formation of double bond, Na2 sodium, Na2, and this carbon, one oxygen, two oxygen, and this your third oxygen, means CO3, and right? Sodium carbonate, and this H will attack on this CH3 negative, and you get corresponding, that is the alkane. So in this way we can write the number of example, right? So in this way you have seen the five preparation, and there is also one more preparation called as a Kolbe synthesis, right? There is also one more preparation, that is a Kolbe synthesis. So it is a 12-3, right? I think you have the lecture at 12-10, right? In this one, if you have any doubt, you may ask. We'll take one more preparation later on, right? So if you have any doubt in this one, right, you may ask. Yes, Siddhi Chavan, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Right. Are you getting? Right,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, are you getting? Okay, right. Yes, check.
Sir, what's reaction? So third example, आपने जो लिया था, एक बार explain करेंगे क्या?
कौन सा third example? Which one? Which reaction?
Wood's reaction.
Wood's reaction. Okay, okay.
Right? Third one.
Yeah. Okay, right. So look here. This is your starting from Grignard region, and this is the starting from your Wood synthesis, right? Wood reaction, right? look here, here is the RX alkyhalide, right?
Yes, sir.
Right, here is the alkyhalide, RX alkyhalide, two molecules of RX alkyhalide. What each other on this R? R positive and X negative, right? R positive and X negative. And sodium is a positive, it is a metal, right? So what happened? The two sodium, it react with two halogen. There is a removal of NaX. Understand? There is a removal of NaX. So here I have written NaX. And this R react with R dash. So here we can also write here R dash, right? So this RR means alkene, RR means alkene. This in general, in particular, methyl bromide, two molecules of methyl bromide react in the presence of sodium. So sodium react with the bromine, there's a formation of NaBr, and this methyl react with methyl and there's a formation of ethane. Understand? Right?
Yes, sir.
So if both are same, then no problem. We can just join this RR. But if the RR, they are separate, right? They are different. So methyl and here is ethyl. So there are the different type of the possibility. Means two molecules of methyl chloride will react. There's a formation of this ethane, right? Two molecules of ethyl chloride will react. There's a formation of N-butane. And also the one methyl and one ethyl will react. So one methyl and one ethyl will react. And there's a formation of N-propane. So you are getting a mixture of these three. Right, so you get the mixed alkane, but out of this one is a major is a in which there are the more number of the carbon atom. Right, even though if you write the major this one, it also work. Even though we don't write, it also work. Right, even though we write the three, but if they ask to write only one, then that time you can write this major compound. Right, so actually you get the three compound. Right, suppose it is a 60%, it is a 20%, 20% like this one. Okay, so in this way we have seen the preparation of this alkyl halide. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Yes. Okay. Other student, if you have any doubt, you may ask. Purchase a book. You can refer the Manali publication book, Nerali publication book, or Organic Chemistry by Morrison Boyd, Organic Chemistry by Clidon. Right. So try to refer all these books and try to read daily so that you can understand the concept. Everything depends upon each other. Whatever things you learn now, that will help you to understand the concept in the next lecture. Okay. Okay. Thanks to all. Right. And here we'll stop. Right. Thanks to all. You can leave the meeting. Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you.
Okay.